I have some bad news. June may have more games than we can handle.
Don't make me choose!
With 3 major franchise titles, tons of expansions and new seasons, plus more loved gaming universes dipping their toes into new genres, there may be too much for us to choose this month, which is why I narrowed it down to 5 for you guys to choose. So wasting no time at all, and presented to you in the order of release date, at number 5 we have Street Fighter 6, coming out June 2nd for PC, PS4, PS5, and finally, after sadly keeping Street Fighter 5 on PlayStation and PC only, all you Xbox fans can get back in the action, as Street Fighter 6 is coming to Xbox Series X and S.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Get back in the action with all your favorite Street Fighter characters, and with a few new ones too. Promising some improved fighting mechanics and an emphasis on street culture, I have high expectations for this one. Plus, a new social spot called the Battle Hub, where you can meet up and hang out with other players and friends. And at number 4 we have Diablo 4, coming out June 6th for everything but Switch. Or if you pre-ordered the deluxe version or higher, you get 4 days early access, and some additional goodies too. Diablo 4 has been a long time coming, and with a lot of recent beta testing, the hype is getting real. With new MMO elements, world bosses, and character creators, those are just a few of the new additions to this franchise. Slash your way through Sanctuary and team up with your friends to take on dungeons and bosses, and get some of that sweet loot. Plus, if you're a couch co-op kind of person, you can still jump into combat side by side in this one, a feature I hope never goes away. And at number 3 we have Crash Team Rumble, releasing June 20th on PS4, PS5, Xbox One, and Xbox Series X and S. This one's gonna be more on the casual side. Team up in this 4v4 multiplayer competition, take control of iconic Crash characters, and a chaotic multiplayer experience to battle to collect more Wumpa Fruit than the other team. Collect cosmetics and emotes, and pick your favorite playstyle. With 12 playable characters, each with their own special abilities, this one's sure to offer a ton of fun. At number 2, we have Aliens Dark Descent, releasing June 20th on everything but Nintendo Switch, and for only $39.99. So if you're looking for something a little lighter on the wallet, this one fits the bill. Aliens Dark Descent is a real-time tactical game with elements similar to XCOM, but with the dark and fantastic world of Alien. So if you're a fan of either, this might be right up your alley. The freedom of movement is much more obvious than other overhead tactical games, with what feels like constant strategy and enemies coming at you from any corner and at any time. Build your fire team and command up to 5 class types. And with all the decisions being permanent, including the death of team members, it adds an extra sense of caution and makes every moment and decision feel important. And at number 1, we have Final Fantasy 16, releasing June 22nd exclusively on PS5. With a new direction for Final Fantasy, and taking a trip back to their old medieval roots, this one's gonna be huge. With a heavy focus on the ARPG genre, no longer do you command a party of companions and stop time to make tactical decisions. Let me take that back. You don't lose party members completely. With your partner in crime, Torgal, your commands more closely resemble that of God of War, with his son and the bow commands. This one's fast-paced and offers some wild abilities that are directly related to iconic powers. Plus, the addition of iconic summon battles is going to be incredible. I have a good feeling about this one. It's really changing up the way we play Final Fantasy games. Plus, keep an eye out for that demo, because it's going to release a couple weeks before launch date. And if you guys want some more details on Final Fantasy 16, make sure to check out my video on the Final Fantasy 16 State of Play. And for more game news, reviews, and more, make sure to hit that subscribe button. As always, thank you guys for sticking around to the end, and I'll see you in the next one.